New details tonight about the first U.S. moon landing in more than 5 decades. Intuitive Machines says its lunar lander has ended up on its side. Well, the private U.S. company says some antennas are covered up, hampering communications, but the lander is still operational. Back here on Earth, some Granite Staters say just being there is a giant leap for the commercial space industry.
The first U.S. moon landing in more than 50 years, and the first private business to pull it off. Houston-based Intuitive Machines is collaborating with NASA. One New Hampshire company says this is just the start.
I would say over the next 5 years, we're going to be beginning to see more and more in-space manufacturing.
John Beam is CEO of Rogue Space Systems, based in Guilford. His company isn't connected to this lunar landing, but he says it sets the tone.
This just shows that the commercial market is really coming on strong, and it's not just big governments doing space anymore.
And that means more people can shoot for the moon.
It opens up so much more. It opens this up to everyone. It's so exciting. People can work for companies all over the country who could play a part in lunar exploration.
Jean Jaroskis is executive director of the McAuliffe-Shepard Discovery Center. She remembers the first mission back in 1972, and now this one is paving the way for humans to return.
Really is the next place for humanity, the next hill that people are always wanting to see what's over the next hill, and the next logical place after exploring Earth is to head to the moon and then on to Mars.
The moon and then Mars. Intuitive Machines anticipates just a week of operations on the moon for the solar-powered lander before lunar nightfall hits.